What was your first sport?
My first sport I done was bodybuilding.
No,
it was boxing.
Oh, sorry. I started off boxing when I was about third form. I was boxing at the gym in Pepetui. It's a little gym, and the coach was Grant at the time. And he's still the coach to this day. But yeah, there was a lot of good boxers that came out of that gym.
How did you get to training?
So I got to training when I was that age. I was actually running to training. So I live in Otara, the gym was in Papatoa, so I ran to training like almost from Monday to Friday, every day.
Yeah.
I was running to training, yeah.
How did you pay for it?
So what I used to do was, I used to sweep the gutters at school, at the school that I went to, De La Salle. Yeah, and I went there, and they had like jobs after school where like you would clean the school and stuff like that too. And they paid like $50 or something, so that was enough to... I think that was a week. And I'd sweep the gutters so I could make some money so I could pay for my membership.
When did you get to fight?
I didn't really get to... Sadly, I didn't get enough to fight because what happened was I was ready. They said, yeah, you're ready to fight. Grant said I was ready to fight, and then he gave me a book, but then I didn't realize. He said I had to go get a doctor's checkup. And the doctor checkup was like about, he told me, yeah, it's gonna cost about $20 or $30 or $100 to get a doctor's clearance so you can fight. And when he told me that, I was, my stomach inside rolled up because I was like, oh man, where am I gonna get that money? So I kind of just stayed away from the gym. And I didn't go back to the gym anymore. And
sweep the gutters.
I was pretty embarrassed that I didn't have enough money to pay for my stuff. I shouldn't have felt like that. That's how I felt. But I seen him again. And I gave him a big hug when I became a champion. Okay. And now I'm a champion. Now I can fight as much as I want and eat as much as I want.
But you still have to keep the weight down.
Yeah. But I gotta keep my weight down.
What's your fighting weight?
My fighting weight? So my fighting weight? No. I'll keep that a secret. Because people might... People out there, you know me, well, I'm coming for you.
What did you do after boxing?
What did I do? Oh, after I did boxing, I lifted weights. You know, I started lifting weights. One of my family members used to own some dumbbells. And I used to go and like just lift the dumbbells in, you know. And I used to do all kind of get creative that just one dumbbell. And then I found out I got really muscly from it was easy for me to do put on muscle. About 3-4 years I haven't been in a gym. But I'm coming. The goal is to get back and do some bodybuilding.
What's your heaviest trend of bodybuilding?
I went up to about like 110 kgs, I think 110, 115.
How old did you do?
I was about 18 years old when I won the juniors for New Zealand and for Auckland. Yeah. I know I won.
What did you eat?
So all I ate was just chicken breast, kumara, and barbecue sauce, and a little bit of peas for the beans, and yeah, that's...
Were you a natural bodybuilder?
Yes, I was a natural bodybuilder. Yeah, natural ass. No steroids. I took protein and some supplements. I drank protein powder and drank glutamine and fish oils and what else?
Vitamin C's.
And vitamin C's. Because you need vitamin C's when you're training really hard to keep you away from the flu.
What did you do after bodybuilding?
So what I did after bodybuilding was I decided to do jiu-jitsu at Steve Oliver's gym. Yeah, I've become no gi and gi champion in New Zealand, yeah. And it's funny because I don't even know the system for the point system. I just go there, I want to go and submit everybody. But I'm coming back. I'm coming for all your necks.
So what did you do after jiu-jitsu?
So I've done that kickboxing, so I've done Muay Thai. Yeah, and I had a couple of, about a year and a half, I've had about 15 fights, 15 to 16 fights, yeah. So, and I took up my, I've won the horse in that amount of time, so it was a year and a half, and I've won a title too in the, in that year and a half that I've done the kickboxing, and I was on King of the Ring. So I won that one. I fought one of the good guys, Cameron, who was a good guy.
Yeah,
then I fought a gentleman by the name of Henry Burns, and I stopped him in the first round with overhand.
Yeah. So how did you feel after you did the
I was hurting him. I knew when I hit him with the right hand, like he went down.
How did you feel? Like,
when he fell down?
Yeah.
Like, I was like, oh man, like, I knew I was gonna stop him. It was all over by then. So, like, I was hitting him, and I could see his eyes rolling back. And I look at the referee and said, oh, he can't take any more, otherwise, I'm gonna kill the guy. So I was looking at the referee and I said, I look, if you watch the fight, yeah. When I'm elbowing him like this, I actually look at the referee, like I pause and look at him for about a split second, and he was like, oh, carry on. So, oh man, I had to go on, and you know, any longer than that, I would have stripped him on his helmet. 25 kilos, more heavier than me, and he was a bit heavier than me, but I felt like I had that one. I thought he was at a disadvantage because he's going to be much bigger, yeah. and I'm going to be much smaller. But on the street, you can fight any man. You can fight a man, you can fight a boy, you can fight a lady.
D for G, stay low.